Good morning, brothers and sisters. I hope that this morning finds you doing well, and I hope that everybody enjoyed their Christmas Day celebration, and you were safe in doing so. We have so many things going on now. So many people are affected and infected by this virus and the pestilence that are going on, and all the other things that are going on around us. But the one constant that we do have is God. God is always God and always will be God. And we're just so thankful that He is, and He's on our side. We want to keep all of our members in prayer who are going through this illness or the various illnesses, and also those who are asking for prayer, the sick and the shut in. Those who are going through bereavement, we know that it is a trying time. It is a trying time. My family is affected by it. Your family is affected by it. The church family is affected by it. The world is affected by it. But I know that God is able. Amen. I know that God is able. So we're going to hold on to that, to know that God is able. Amen. There is a word today. There's a word today, and we know this is the last Sunday of the year 2020. And boy, what a year it's been. But we thank God for God being God, because if it had not been for the Lord who's on our side, He has brought us through this year. We know that we've lost some loved ones, and we've had some heartaches and pains and disappointments. But I'm so glad that God is allowing us to see the last Sunday of this year, and we're praying that He brings us over into a new year, a new beginning. Amen. So please join me in a word of prayer before we go into our word. Our Father, we come this morning thanking You for being God all by Yourself, thanking You for being a loving and caring Father, thanking You for things being as well as they are. Father, I know that You have all power in Your hands, and I know that in Your timing, You will make everything all right. Father, we thank You for those who are viewing this broadcast and getting into Your word and getting closer to You. Father, we are praying right now for those who are sick, those who are shut in, those who are in the hospital, those who are suffering from this virus. We know that You have all power. You're still a healer, and You haven't lost any of Your power. And we thank You. We thank You right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we ask that You give comfort to those who are in bereavement. We pray for those who are in financial stress and strain, that You relieve them of that, Father, because You will supply all of their need. And we believe this with all faith. Father, bless Your word, and bless the doers and hearers of Your word. These and other blessings we ask in Thy Son Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Our word for today is found in the book of Psalms. In the book of Psalms. And the 71st number of the book of Psalms. Psalm 71. Amen. And we'd like to read a few verses today. Normally I just jump from one verse and go with that, but we want to read a few verses today, starting at that fourth verse of that 71st number of Psalms. So in that fourth verse, the writer says, "Deliver me, O my God, out of the hand of the wicked, out of the hand of the unrighteous and cruel man. For You are my hope, O Lord God. You are my trust from my youth. By You, I have been upheld from birth. You are He who took me out of my mother's womb. My praise shall continually be of You." Amen. We'd like to speak from a subject today. We all have something to praise God for. We all have something to praise God for. When I think about where we live, how we live in this world, looking at the vast scheme of things. We live in a world that's full of sin and evil. The sin and evil in which we encounter are perpetrated by wicked people. It's exhibited by folks who are unrighteous. And there are threats and dangers everywhere and at all times. At any time, something bad, quote unquote, can happen. There are threats and dangers to ourselves and even threats and dangers to the ones whom we love. And even when things seem safe and secure, the possibility of an attack is ever present. You can look at that as back in September the 11th, 2001, when the United States thought that we were the strongest nation in the world, and infiltrators came in and bombed the Capitol and the New York Trade Centers and the Pentagon, and you know, things like that can happen. Evil and wickedness is everywhere. And whether we like it or not, we have to live and we have to walk among and amidst the wicked of this world and the evil of this world. My brothers and sisters, I don't want you to be deceived. Just because you're saved, don't think that you're exempt from the presence of wickedness that may affect our lives in some way. Paul says in Romans 7 and 21, he says, I find then a law that when I would do good, evil is always present, which means that I can live the best I can, but there's evil somewhere lurking about trying to mess up what I'm doing. See, given the threats and dangers, we need protection from this. We need a shield. We need a buckler. And the protection that we need can't come from the police, can't come from any military action. It can't come from any other human being. But the kind of protection that we need can only be given by the Lord. We need the Lord to deliver us from the hand of the wicked. The things that are going on around us, a lot of times, are not because of that man himself, but it's because of the wicked devices of Satan used by that man. Remember when Paul wrote the church at Ephesus, he said, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers and dark powers of darkness and rulers and evil and wickedness in high places. This is what we're wrestling against. And only God can give us the protection against that kind of power. That's why Jesus told his disciples when they pray, they should include in their prayer the request to God to deliver us from evil. We need to walk. We need him to walk with us. We need him to walk with our loved ones through life to keep us from falling into the snares of the wicked, because Satan is a clever being, and he can trip us up just like that. But God can deliver us from the snare of the fowler. Psalm 140 and 1 says, deliver me, O Lord, from the evil man. Preserve me from the violent man. Psalm 141 and 10 says, let the wicked fall into their own nets while we escape safely. Psalm 142 and 5 says, I cried unto thee, O Lord. I said, thou art my refuge and my portion in the land of the living. Psalm 143 and 9 says, deliver me, O Lord, Lord, from thine enemies. I flee unto thee to hide me. All of these prayers are asking the Lord to protect us from the attacks of our enemies, because a lot of times we don't even know who our enemy is. We know who the ultimate enemy is. It's Satan, and the spirit of Satan can get into beings, can get into humans, can, as we found in the book of Genesis, can get into animals and cause us or influence us to do a lot of things. We need the protection of God. We need him physically. We need him emotionally. We need him psychologically. We need the protection of God to keep our enemies at bay. And there's a reason why we can expect God to walk with us and to help us and to protect us. And that reason is because we trust in the Lord. I wish I had a witness in here. See, the psalmist who writes from the perspective of somebody of old age, somebody who's had experience. See, some of us have trusted in the Lord from our youth unto this present time. However long it's been, the Lord has provided us with protection thus far, and there's no good reason why he should stop now. There's no good reason why the Lord should withdraw his hand or stop smiling on our situations. We can count on the Lord. That's why we trust him. That's why Isaiah says in Isaiah 26:3, he keeps him in perfect peace whose mind stays on him because he trusts in him. David says in Psalm 37:25, he says, I've been young. And I know if I had a church here, I know you can finish this. I've been young and now am old. Yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken. I see some of y'all out there quoting this with me. I have not seen the righteous forsaken nor his seed begging bread. And that word stands today because some of us can testify and we realize that we are here because of somebody else's prayer for God's protection on our lives. I wish I had a witness in here. You might not be able to testify. That might be your testimony. But my testimony this morning is that I'm here because I know somebody prayed for me. I had a praying grandmother. I had a praying father. I got a praying mother. Somebody prayed for me. And that's why I know that I got something to praise God for. All of us, we all have something to praise God for. The Lord God saw to our safety even from birth. When we were being carried inside of our mother's womb, God watched over us. God protected us even before we were able to trust him. He was still taking care of us. He could have allowed some dreadful illness to befall us when we came out of the womb, but he kept us. That's enough to praise God for right there. And although we may have to go through some difficult times, although there may be some attacks from the enemy, although we've made some stupid mistakes in our lives, the Lord has still upheld us and delivered us out of our messes. I wish I had a help in. I wish I had some help out there. See, David says in Psalm 34:19, he said, many are the afflictions of the righteous. Just because you're saved, you're still going to have afflictions. But he came back and he said, but the Lord. See, that's praiseworthy right there. Even though I know I'm going to go through some trials and tribulations, but the Lord, I'm going to have people lie on me. I'm going to be criticized, but the Lord, I'm going to have some dangers unseen and dangers seen to come before me, but the Lord shall deliver him or me out of them all. We all have something to praise God for because we can look back and we can see that we've been through some stuff in our past and in 2020, and the Lord is still bringing us through. This enough to praise God. I wish I had somebody that'll shout one time that the Lord is still blessing me. Amen. When we think of all the threats and all the dangers in life that could have destroyed us and could have destroyed our family, when we think of all the times disasters have come to take us out, but it didn't. We turn to the Lord with gratitude. When we can think of the time when we were wild and foolish and we didn't get hurt, we have to tell the Lord, thank you for that. When sickness was upon us, And death didn't get the victory, we should realize how blessed we are. We have so much to praise God for right now. Even in the midst of all of this stuff, we have so much to praise God for right now. No matter how things may look because of what the Lord has already brought us through, we should continue to praise God for being our God. See, David said, I will bless the Lord at all times. In good times, I'll bless the Lord. In bad times, I'll bless the Lord. When I'm up, I'm going to bless him. When I'm down, I'm going to bless the Lord. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My brothers and sisters, as we look back over our lives, especially in the year of 2020, We have so much to be thankful for in the midst of all of this chaos, in the midst of all of this pestilence, in the midst of all of this sickness, in the midst of all of this death. God is still keeping us. And that's why I'm saying to you today that we all have something to praise God for. And if you're still sitting there saying, I've had it rough, Pastor, you don't understand. You hadn't gone through what I've gone through. You may be right, my brother and sister. You may be right on this morning because of the situation you're going through. But if you can't think of anything else to praise God for, just think about what he did for you on Calvary's Hill. He shed his precious blood. First of all, he came down from glory, born, walked the streets with all kind of sinful men, hung up on a cross on Calvary's Hill, shed his blood to cover your sins and mine, and died. And after 3 days, God raised him from the dead with all power in his hand. We all have something to praise God for. My situation might not be your situation, but I bet you I can find something that I can praise God for. He's already done enough that I can praise him the rest of my life. We all are going to have hard times. We all are going to have hard times, but I'm still going to praise him through the hard time, because when he delivered me out of those before, he's going to deliver me out of these right now. And I'm not just talking about me. I'm talking about all of us. So we all have something to praise God for. God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. Getting a little excited there. May God continue to bless you. I got to get out of here, but we thank you for your continued support of this ministry. Thank you for your financial blessings, your spiritual blessing, your prayers for me and this ministry. We ask that you continue, as I continue to pray for you. We will be back at the house again the second Saturday in January for our contributions unto the Lord. And we just thank you for all that you're doing. We'll be back Saturday, January the 9th at 10 a.m. And if you're mailing it in, it's Mizpah Baptist Church, Post Office Box 1275, Baxley, Georgia, 31515. That's Mizpah Baptist Church, Post Office Box 1275, Baxley, Georgia, 31515. Amen. Remember, as I said, keep our members in prayer. You can be as safe as you want to be, but this thing is real. I have some co-workers who are suffering from COVID, and they're in the hospital, and we pray their strength as well, that God continue to bless them and bring them out. Amen. And families that are take care of the sick, we're praying for your strength, and also the frontline workers who are taking care of those who are sick, the teachers and all the essential workers. We're praying for you and your strength and your wellness as well. Amen. Remember, early voting has started, so you have until Thursday, December 31st, to go out and cast your early vote. The next time you'll be able to vote will be January the 5th. It'll be Tuesday, January 5th. So go out and do it early so you won't be in a long line. Or if you have a ballot, a mail-in ballot, go ahead and cast that mail-in ballot. And when you go out, make sure that you are masked up. Make sure that you're masked up. Mask up, baby, so you'll be safe. Amen. And protect yourself and protect others from you. Amen. I got to get out of here. I love y'all. I pray that God will keep us until we're able to meet again. Have a wonderful day, and we hope we said something that's going to encourage you and strengthen you and give you something to think about and to praise God for. We love you, and we're out.